Stephen Losey, welcome back to the show.
Glad to be here.
The F-35 is having some troubles with its engine. What is going on there?
The F-35 is the cornerstone of the Air Force's future fighter fleet, but it's having some availability issues. The Government Accountability Office recently found that in recent years, about 17% of the time, the F-35 hasn't been available due to some spare parts issues. And most of the time, that's been due to a lack of the available and ready F-135 engines that are made by Pratt and Whitney.
What are they doing to fix it?
So the Air Force, one of the things that the Air Force is doing is trying to improve the and expand the depot capacity that it uses to maintain these F-135 engines. The biggest depot facility is at Tinker Air Force Base in Oklahoma City. And they've had some notable success in recent years. Beginning in 2021, took Tinker about 244 days on average to maintain the an F-135 engine. They've now gotten that down to about 106.
The story that you wrote in Defense News is pretty interesting because part of their successes was hiring, which is something that has been really difficult for the rest of us to do, but that actually has been a success in this, and it's helped them kind of move things along.
That's right. One of the problems that they found is that because the F-135 engine is so new, there's not a whole lot of maintainers on the job market who have experience with that kind of engine. So they had to build it from the ground up. About 5 years ago, there were about 17 mechanics that Tinker had on hand. They've now gotten that up to 103, and they're hoping to hire more to expand their capacity to maintain more engines from about 30 to 40 at any given time. But one thing they also did was they tried to revamp how they train mechanics. Used to be they would try to train them on multiple parts of the F-135 maintenance process. They decided to break that up into chunks and have mechanics learn just a single step, doing it over and over again, breaking down the steps until they became experts at that one little section of the process.
And those mechanics, are they civilian or are they active duty military?
They are almost entirely civilian, which is an advantage for Tinker because they aren't required to move to new assignments after every couple of years. Here's one other thing they did. They reached out to the contractor that makes the F-135 engine, Pratt & Whitney, and sent some of their mechanics and staff to Pratt & Whitney's facilities in Connecticut, where they spoke straight to the people who make the engine and learned directly from them the best ways to disassemble, reassemble engines so it goes a lot smoother.
Stephen, as we know, in order to solve a problem, you need to know what the problem is. How did the Air Force identify which problems to fix at Tinker Air Force Base Depot?
At the beginning of 2021, Tinker started taking a close look at all of the processes they used to maintain the F-135 engine. They found there were several points in which there were log jams, choke points in the process, places that they could reorganize things, and they set out to try to clear up those log jams in the process. Another thing they found was that in some cases, the mechanics either didn't have the right kind of equipment or they didn't have enough of the equipment that they needed to work on these engines at crucial points. And that became a problem because there were times when F-135 engines were just kind of starting to pile up because they needed to go through this next phase, but the mechanics didn't have the tools to fix them. So that created problems when there just weren't enough. So they went through and figured out what kind of new and additional pieces of equipment that they needed and set out to make sure that they would get into the F-135 Tinker mechanics' hands.
Okay, so the mechanics, they may have had enough people, but not enough tools?
That's right.
One really interesting part of your story that I read is that, you know, these engines don't fly in sterile environments. They're in austere places like, you know, the sand out in the desert. They are on Navy ships, and that breaks them down. How does that play a role in so many engines being out of pocket right now?
Well, one thing they discovered, as you said, is the sand in the desert environment, as well as the salt in a sea environment. Some of these F-35s are on aircraft carriers. That has a corrosive effect on the turbine blades inside the engines. And Pratt & Whitney developed a new engine blade coating that they're trying to install on F-135 engines to make them more resistant and have them last longer. I believe about last fall, about a quarter of the F-135 engines had this new turbine blade coating. They've made some progress since then. It's now at about 35%. And Pratt & Whitney is hopeful that by 2030, maybe earlier, all of the F-135 engines will have this new turbine blade coating.
And it looks like the depot at Tinker Air Force Base in Oklahoma has found its stride. It's one location in one spot. Is the Air Force or perhaps other services looking at those successes and seeing if they can replicate them somewhere else?
That's right. Naval Air Station Jacksonville in Florida is going to start up their own F-135 depot facility in the next couple of years. It's going to be roughly comparable in size and capacity to what Tinker has. And Tinker has been compiling all the lessons that they've learned from Pratt & Whitney for their Jacksonville counterparts when they come online, so they can learn from what Tinker has gone through and perhaps get a jump on things.
Stephen, thank you so much. That and many more of your stories on DefenseNews.com.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
And up next is Defense Dollars.